Fans have been following the X Factor win. Our final guest today cannonballed to the top of the charts with their first two singles and have earned their wings as a top pop group. Gifted, there must be something in their DNA. Hey. Please welcome Little X. Your album is DNA.
Yes.
The single is DNA.
Yes.
What's it all about? Tell us a bit about the single, first of all. What's it about?
Well, the single is basically a love song with a bit of a darker twist. And we just wanted to show, like, another side to it compared to Wings, because Wings was very uplifting, very upbeat. So DNA is a bit of a darker side.
Yeah.
And kind of a reflection on the rest of the album as well.
And does the video for it reflect that darker side?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. We went to play, like, characters, didn't we? Yeah.
Did you do a bit
of Psycho Sally's in it?
We did. Yeah. Perry's got a guy tied up in the car.
Oh,
I've got a shrine. Yeah, it's pretty dark.
Oh, let's take a little look. Spice Girls one where they were up, you know, flying through space and it was all quiet. Do you know, I can't remember which song it was for, but do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
yeah. That's it.
Oh, yeah.
was that filmed on the top of a, you know, construction project in the middle of New York somewhere?
No.
We wish
it was.
It was all green screen.
It was all green screen. Yeah. We had to pretend.
But it was still in the dark.
How much input have you had in the writing and everything, doing the album?
We've been so lucky, haven't we, to have so much input. But I think we said from the start that we wanted as much input as possible. Mm. I mean, obviously it's best if it comes mostly from us anyway, so...
Yeah. We've written and co-written about 9 songs on the album.
Have you? Yeah. For you.
We try to do as much as we could in the time we had, really.
Yeah. Also, it's good money, that love. Always get the writing.
And have you had a little bit of advice? We were talking about, you know, whether it's right for older people to give younger people advice. Have you had any? Have you been given any? Have you taken it?
Yeah. It started from Talisa, didn't it, on the show? Like, she gave us so much support.
Do you still talk to Talisa? Are you still in touch with her?
I still speak to her. Well, we saw her, obviously, when we went back on The X Factor.
Of course. Mm.
Every time we see her, it's just so lovely to catch up with her, because obviously we're all so busy at the moment. But, when we do see it, it's really, really nice.
Yeah, but she's not exactly old. Does she?
No.
I mean, you know, do you take advice from your parents?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
From her.
Yeah.
Your mum's
always
old.
Giving us advice.
Your
mum?
40 years.
Get out.
You're going on tour next year?
Yes.
We are so excited.
Tickets are on sale, so get your tickets.
Is it a big tour? Where is it?
It's a theatre tour, all over the UK. And we thought we'd start in a theatre, so it was more intimate, get involved with all the crowd and everything. So we're really, really looking forward to that.
We can't wait.
Well, we were also talking as well about striving for perfection. Mm. I mean, you all look very polished. Is perfection something that you try to achieve in your work?
I think with looks-wise, we're not really that bothered. But I think with performances and things like that, we definitely strive for perfection.
We always pick ourselves apart on every single performance, and we just want to strive to be better every single time. So.
But are you looking for the perfect man in your life, or you're not even thinking about that at this stage?
I don't think he exists.
He doesn't, though.
Well, nobody's perfect, are they? But like, someone could be perfect for you, I think.
Yeah. But not. He'll never be perfect, like... I don't think
Well, do you know, even if they were, it'd be really irritating.
Exactly. Yeah. It's a good thing, isn't it?
There's nothing worse than a boyfriend who's just too nice.
Oh, I don't know.
Mary's done all right, haven't you?